Wind and solar power generation is expanding, but one challenge we face is how to store that energy when the sun isn't shining or the wind isn't blowing. Here are three innovative companies searching for breakthroughs to solve this challenge.
For the first time ever, renewable power is cheaper than fossil intensive fuel sources. I mean, that's a remarkable statement. Malta's mission is to enable the supply of reliable, resilient, and affordable electricity anywhere in the world. And we're doing that by developing an energy storage technology that is long duration and cost competitive. The Malta system is very simple. On the front end, as the electricity comes in, it basically operates a heat pump. What you're doing is taking the hot side and storing that in molten salt. And salt stores heat very well. And you're taking the cold side and storing that in an antifreeze solution. And then when the electricity is needed to go back out to the grid, what you're doing is basically reversing that process.
Quinette is taking the largest form of energy storage today, which is called pumped hydro storage, effectively running water up and down a hill. And we're just bringing that to regions where there are no hills and it's all flat terrain. For pumped hydro storage, the majority of the cost is building the dam and constructing on the side on the top of a mountain. With Quinette's subsurface geomechanical pump storage, we take that cost and bring it down about an order of magnitude. Quinette facility essentially involves a surface pond, a mechanical room, and a well. When the system is charging, water is pulled from the pond and pumped down into the well and kept at high pressure. When we're discharging, the high pressure water is allowed to come back up through the well, flowing through the turbine and back into the pond.
Foreman Energy's bidirectional power plants are quite different from other kinds of energy storage. Lithium ion is the one that most people know, whereas lithium ion batteries are fantastic sprinters. You would never take a sprinter and ask that sprinter to run a marathon. In our case, what we are going after is a very different kind of race. And that marathon racer is a different electrochemical challenge to smooth out those intermittencies over long periods of time, days, weeks, or potentially even months. The bidirectional power plant operates under the same principles that any energy storage device does. You have a source of charging, and then it's discharged according to the value maximizing algorithm that we have developed. We use earth abundant elements, and we use elements which are non-toxic and very benign.
Every day I can wake up and tell myself that I'm doing something about climate change, that I'm doing something that matters, that will matter to my children's generation.
The window for solving these problems isn't that long. Being able to dedicate our capabilities to doing something about that is what fundamentally keeps us going and excited.
Humans are incredibly and endlessly inventive. I do like the idea that we're just going to go do it.